Hello, and welcome back to the PI WebParts 2013 SP1 installation video series. In the previous video, we configured and did all the post-installation steps for PI WebParts, and in this video, we will be setting up PI security for PI WebParts. For the PI server, I will show it using both PI mappings and PI trusts. The recommendation is to use PI mappings, though, and I'll also show it for AF security, which has to use the active directory credentials. So in order to set up PI security, I'm going to have to bring up PI system management tools. I don't have this on my PI WebParts services machine, so I'm going to jump over to my PI server. This is my PI server, and I'm going to bring up PI system management tools. Now, I'm going to start with PI mapping. So in order to create a PI mapping, you have to first create an identity that the mapping is going to use. This identity is what grants the user the correct credentials. So the account is going to be mapped to this identity, and then the identity is going to be giving the credentials needed. In order to create the identity, under the Security tab in System Management Tools, you'll see Identities, Users, and Groups. Select that. You'll have to run it as administrator, so if you did not do that initially, you'll have to restart it under different credentials, and I'll just run it as administrator for you. And on the PI Identities tab, you can add an identity. I've already created one for the PI WebParts service account. So the credentials the service account is going to need is read access to the PIPoint database and read access to all of the PI points, both the data and the point security. So that's where we're going to have to give this identity permissions to. If you did not already create the identity, you can right-click in the white space, do new identity, and just type in a name. And once you type in a name, you can just do create. Again, I've already created my identity, so I'm going to use this PI WebParts services account. So now that I have the identity, I know the permissions that the service account needs. I need to actually give this identity those permissions. The first one I mentioned is it has to have permissions to the PIPoint database. In order to give it those permissions, you go to the database security underneath security, and you'll find PIPoint. If you double click it, you can edit the permissions. You'll see I already have PI WebParts services account there, but if you do not, select Add. Find the identity you created for your service account. In my case, it's PI WebParts service account. Select Add and do OK. And then with that highlighted, you just want to make sure that it has read permissions. It does not need write. And then once you have that correct, you can just select OK. And you can see in this long string, you have PI WebParts services and it has read access. So that's all you need to do here. The next is, as I mentioned, the service account needs read access to all of the PI points data and point security. In order to do that, you go to Points, Point Builder, then just search for any of your tags or your points. I'm going to search for Sinusoid. And once you have that point selected, go to the Security tab, and you'll see Point Security and Data Security. The PI service account that's running, the service account that is running PI WebParts services will need read access to both of these. In order to do that, you select Add, find your PI WebParts service account identity, select Add, do OK, and then it'll be added. And then when you select it, you want to make sure to deselect write, it has just read access, and do the same for data security. I've already done the same, but I've already done it over here on data security, but if you've not, again, just select Add, find your identity, select Add, and again, just make sure it only has read access. Once you set that up, you can just save it. You're going to need that to do that for every single one of your tags. Doing that in PI System Management Tools will take a very long time, and I do not recommend it. So in order to speed it up, you can use what's called PI Tag Configurator, which is an add-in to Excel. For more information on that, You can see our PI server administration guide, and you can also view some videos in the PI server administration playlist on YouTube, which will help you change the tag settings using PI Tag Configurator. I'm not going to go through that in this video. I've already done so. So all my tags now have given read access to this identity. Now that we've given the correct permissions to the identity we're going to use, we actually have to map the service account running PI WebParts services application pool to this identity. In order to do that, you go to Security, Mappings and Trusts, and then under the Mappings tab, you'll see I have nothing. So right now, if that service account tries to connect, it actually will not be granted any permissions. It won't be able to connect. So to change that, I have to create a new mapping. Either click this button here at the top or right-click in the white space and do New Mapping. And I'll have to find the Windows account. So I'll click these three dots. I know it's PI Web Clients SV. I'll check the names. TS, PI Web Clients is the account I had. And you'll see when I do check names after putting in correctly, it shows up. Select OK. And now I have to map this to that identity I've granted permissions to. So if I do these three dots, it'll show up all the identities. I'll find PI Web Parts service account, select OK, and OK. So now, when this service account tries to connect, which is the one running my PI Web Parts services application pool, it will be granted the identity PI Web Parts service account. And that PI Web Parts service account, since I just configured it, has read access to the PIPoint database and read access to the point and data security for all the PIPoints. Now that you've granted the correct permissions to your service account, you will also want to grant permissions to all the users that are going to use PI Web Parts. So if you set up Kerberos correctly, the service account can connect right now, but the actual user will not be able to see anything. To do that, it's the same things as the service account. So again, you want to create an identity first. I've already created one called PI Web Parts User. That user needs read access to the PIPoint database, which you can see if I double click, I've already given it that access. And it will also need read access to all the points that this user is allowed to see. So not every user might be able to see every point for different security reasons. So you can actually give certain permissions to certain accounts. For this PI Web Parts user, you'll see that it has access, read access to Sinusoid and CDT-158. But it does not have access to a different tag called BALevel.1. So you'll see there's no PI Web Parts user here. With my current configuration, any user that uses the PI Web Part user identity will only have access to Sinusoid and CDT-158. Now I'm going to want to map all the users that get these permissions to that identity. So again, goes to Mappings and Trusts. I'll do a new mapping. And I'm going to use my user. And I'm going to give myself the PI Web Parts user permission. So the service account has read access to all of your PI points in the PI point database, but your user only needs read access to the PI point database and read access to the PI points that it's allowed to see, which is not necessarily all of them. So I've now set up my PI Web Parts, my PI security for PI Web Parts using PI mappings. I will test out and make sure these work in our next video. But for now, I'm also going to show you how to create a PI trust to allow this in. Again, we recommend PI mappings, and if you've set up Kerberos, use PI mappings. But if you're unable to set up Kerberos, then you can use a PI trust. A disadvantage of a PI trust is every user will have access to all the points that you allow this trust to. So if you do want certain users to only have access to certain points, then you will not want to use a PI trust, because then everyone will have the exact same access. With PI mappings and Kerberos, depending on your mappings, you can give different users different access to different points. But if you do want to create a trust, you can right-click and do New Trust, or just do this down arrow, and I like Advanced. When you select Advanced, you'll see this window. So I'll call this PI WebParts. You can name it whatever you'd like. I'm just going to use the network path, which is Sterling. But if you want to use the IP address, you can use that. But if you use the IP address, just make sure the net mask is 255 all the way across. If you do different numbers here, you're going to be granting more access than you'd like. Since I am using the network path, I do not want IP address or net mask. For the application name, it's called w3wp.exe. This is what SharePoint will connect as with this application. And then for PI identity, I'm actually just going to use PI WebParts service account, because this one has read access to all my points. And just select OK. And you'll see it added here. Now that we've configured both mappings and trusts for PI security, we can go ahead and set up AF security. We do that using PI System Explorer. And you can open that up to your AF server. Now the permissions that the service account running the PI WebParts services application pool will need is read access to the server, read access to the databases collection, read access to all the databases that you will like to see in PI WebParts, and read access to all of the elements you'd like to see in PI WebParts. So I'll show you how to do that. To change the server and the databases collection, you go to Database. Then you click the three dots next to your AF server. Right-click your AF server and you'll see Security, and Server is the first one you want to change. So right now everyone has read access, so actually that's fine. But if you don't have everyone, then you're going to need to add your service account. While you're here, you can also add all of the users that you'd want to be able to see data from this server, because the users that are connecting to PI WebParts will need read access to the server, read access to the databases collection, read access to any database that that specific user is allowed to see, and read access to all of the elements that specific user is allowed to view. So I'll go ahead and add my user here as well. And they only need read access, so we'll take away all the access it does not need. To add read access to the databases collection, again, you right-click your AS server, go to Security, you'll see Databases, and then Databases again. And again, you add them the same way. And you want to add read data as well. And again, I'm going to add my user as well. You can add groups here instead of just users in order to make it a little bit quicker to configure and easier to maintain. Now you're also going to want to add, again, the service account and the user to the database that you want it to be able to view. So to do that, you click on your specific database and you'll see Security and Database. And again, we'll just do the add. Give it just read access, and we'll add the user as well. And finally, you need read access to all the elements that you'd want to be able to see. Again, the service account and the users. So once you're in your database, you just right-click one of the elements and select Security, and just like before, we add them again. I forgot to add the user. Now this only changes the permissions for the one element we're on. If you want to change the permissions for all its child elements as well, you click this Advanced. And you'll see this replace all child object permissions with inheritable permissions from this object. So I'll select that. If I click OK, it'll give me a warning saying it's going to do that. I'll just select Yes. Now all of the child elements have this same access. Be warned though, it does replace whatever security was there before. And with that, now in PI WebParts, we would be able to see equipment maintenance, but I have everyone has read access to everything, so we'll be able to see everything. If you ever need to be reminded of what permissions to give the service account and users to your AF and PI servers, it is in your PI WebParts administrative guide. It'll tell you exactly where you need to give everything read access. So if you ever forget, go ahead and take a look there. But now we've set up security. In the next video, we will take a look and test our WebParts to make sure everything is working properly. And as I mentioned before, I will test using both the PI mappings, which is recommended, as well as the PI truss.